I actually have a very personal take on this actually. It's kind of like reading the story and then kind of realizing what I want to draw. Like, what would I want to like? What am I most excited about drawing? And that's like one aspect of it. I also think it depends on the kind of picture book that you're with. If you are doing a book where the text is less and like the whole storytelling really depends on like the image, then obviously that, it takes up most. I have actually an example of like. What's nice about it is that the story is about the images, there are these large, beautiful images and they're there and like they're the ones that are effectively pushing the story forward. And like the text is there, but it's like mostly, picture, the story is driven by the pictures. And so you could have, I think that if you depended more on the text, I do not think that the spirit of the story would have come out, and like you needed visuals in order to like, get this to push the story along. So this is a very lovely book that way.
Can you see the cover once?
It's called Goal.
Okay,
Yeah.
super.
So I do feel like it also depends from project to project, like from book to book as well. It is, I wouldn't say a trial and error method. Like sometimes when I read the text and I have to come up with the illustrations, it's something that, you can kind of see in your mind that I think it comes with a lot more practice because obviously what I pitch first is not usually what goes forward. Like there is a collaboration, and so if you have maybe picked like pitched for like doing a full double page spread, maybe the client, your editor will have a better idea of like, okay, no, like it should be like this. So that sort of like conversation also helps. So I don't think like there is a formula really for like deciding when either image works or what kind of image works. It really is a very organic process, I guess. It's very difficult to describe it, I think.